Now, coming to the next part, and there are different circuits for each. Okay. Now, coming to the microprocessors. First of all, why this microprocessor is present in the digital syllabus? Why? Because microprocessor is a digital device. So, microprocessor is basically a digital device. That's why it's a part of, okay, the digital syllabus. Now, and generally for the gate, you have 8085 microprocessor, both for the EC as well as EEE, you have 8085 microprocessor. And the topics in this microprocessor is architecture and programming, memory and I/O interfacing. Now, remember, you are good at digital electronics and you are very weak at microprocessor. There is no meaning in the subject, because the the core application will come in microprocessors. Because inside the microprocessors, there are decoders, there are registers, there are counters, there are thematic circuits inside. And all those things you are going to manufacture or you're going to design with the help of digital basics. And as a whole, if you don't know what is microprocessor and how it is programming or how it is doing, and what is the architecture, how you're going to do interfacing, then there is no meaning in the digital subject. So that's why this microprocessor is a part of digital syllabus. And remember, this microprocessor is very important, and there is a very good weightage for this microprocessor in GATE exam. Definitely every year one, two marks question is coming, some programming question is coming. And if you sit for interviews, there are some questions. How many registers are there? How many general purpose registers are there inside the microprocessor? And how many instructions are there inside a microprocessor? And what is the architecture used? How many interrupts are there? What is the clock frequency? They are the different types of questions they'll ask in the interviews. So don't ignore the microprocessor. This is a very important part. Even if you ignore, remember, it is going to catch in your higher studies, in your companies. Every system nowadays, every electronic gadgets or systems nowadays, the heart is microprocessor. Heart, or you can call brain, is a microprocessor. Without microprocessor, it is difficult to imagine a system nowadays. So don't ignore the microprocessor. Okay. Now, coming to the architecture. So if you want to understand the remaining concepts of the microprocessor architecture, you have to be very good. What is present inside? Architecture basically is nothing but how exactly a microprocessor looks inside. If you cut open the chip, nothing you will see, because everything is transistors. Right? Now, if you want to understand the operation, you should have an overview. Okay, so that overview is given by overview of the microprocessor. Okay, design is given by the architecture. So basically, microprocessor has basically three units. Okay, in short, microprocessor, I can call it as, it is nothing but arithmetic logic unit, it is a control unit, plus a set of registers. That's it. Nothing else is there in the microprocessor. Only three things: arithmetic logic unit, control unit, and set of registers. These three units integrated in a single silicon chip, it is called as microprocessor. All these three units in a single chip, remember, not different chips. If they are in different chips, ALU is a different chip, CU is a different unit, and set of registers, three different units, then you don't call it as a microprocessor, you call it as a central processing unit. Now the question is, what is the difference between a CPU as well as a microprocessor? It's the basic interview question. In the interview is, they'll ask this question: is microprocessor same as CPU? The answer is microprocessor a CPU? Yes, the answer is yes. Every microprocessor is a CPU with ALU, CU set of registers, okay, in a single integrated chip. If they are not in a single chip, then simply call it as a CPU, central processing unit. Now, this is about the microprocessor. So in the arithmetic logic unit, okay, you will find so many different circuits: adder circuits, subtractor circuits, okay, comparator circuits, and you will find some logical circuits, shifting circuits, and all those things will present in the arithmetic and logic unit. In control unit, these control unit, at what time the addition should take place, at what time the data should be transferred from the microprocessor to memory, or from memory to microprocessor, or what time the arithmetic operation should take place. All the operations will be controlled by this control unit. And coming to the set of registers. So these set of registers, there are certain set of registers in the microprocessor. Okay, these registers are B, C, D, E, H, L. Apart from this, there is one more register, A. So these registers are 8-bit registers, and these registers are used to store some numbers or data. Right. So basically, they are not memory, they are simple registers. Okay, now you put the registers as well as memory slightly differently. So don't mix up the memory. Memory is totally a different unit. So these registers inside the microprocessor, they are used to store some certain numbers. If you want to add some two numbers, first you store the numbers and then you perform the calculations using ALU unit. So the architecture completely deals with these things. Okay. It deals with the ALU unit, control unit, and a set of registers. Now coming to the programming, very important in the programming. So now you are very good at architecture, no doubt about it. But you are very weak in programming. There is no point in knowing the architecture. The main purpose of knowing the architecture is to understand the programming. How the data is coming into the microprocessor. Okay. How the data is coming into the microprocessor, how it is going out, and what is happening inside the microprocessor. All those analysis, the data movement analysis that you can understand by looking into the microprocessor only if you know programming, if you are good at programming. If you want to be good at programming in the microprocessor, the first thing is you should be good at the instruction set. The instruction set is very, very important. There are total 74 instructions in 8085 microprocessor. Not one or two. 74 basic instructions are there. And there are 246 opcodes. Now, all the 74 instructions, if you are perfect, that is analyzing each and every instruction clearly and understanding and memorizing each instruction. Okay, all the 74 instructions you can put into 7 groups. The data transfer group, the first group. The second group is arithmetic group of instructions. The third group is logical group of instructions. The fourth group is branch group of instructions. The fifth group is I/O related group of instructions. The sixth group is a stack related group of instructions. The seventh group is, it is the machine related group of instructions. If you are good at these 7 group of instructions, that is total 74 instructions, you can play with the microprocessor. In simple to say, you can play with the microprocessor. And definitely 2 marks, will be in your basket. So programming plays a vital role in microprocessor. So if you are good at programming, remember, you are done with the microprocessor. Okay, from the exam point of view, from the knowledge point of view, both. And from the interviews point of view also. So don't ignore the programming. And what exactly you have to study, I'm going to tell you. In the each instruction set, every instruction is having some characteristics. For example, for every instruction you should know, the first thing is its function, how it is exactly functioning, or what is the purpose of the instruction. That is the first thing. Second thing is how many bytes it will occupy, 1 byte or 2 byte or 3 byte, and how many machine cycles does it has, and what are the types of machine cycles, and how many T states, and how much time does it take to execute. So if you know these characteristics for every instruction, 74 instructions, don't think it is difficult. A little practice is required, that's it. A little focus and practice is required, and easily you can memorize all the 74 instructions with a little practice, that's it, over. And have confidence. Okay, easily you can memorize all the 74. And afterwards, you just see. You'll be playing with microprocessor, nothing else. And now once the programming is done, you have to know the memory and I/O interfacing. What is this? First of all, interfacing. Interfacing is nothing but it is a technique of connecting the devices to the microprocessor. 8085 microprocessor has total 40 pins. Now, hundreds of devices you are connecting to this microprocessor. How is it possible having only just 40 pins? Using a technique called as interfacing techniques. So these interfacing are nothing but techniques how you are going to connect the devices to the microprocessor. If you are connecting memory to the microprocessor, it is called as memory interfacing. If you are connecting the input-output devices, it is called as I/O interfacing to the microprocessor. Very rarely a question is coming from this interfacing, but however, okay, the basics you have to know about this memory and I/O interfacing.